Assalamu alaikum. Today lecture will be echo for veno arterial ECMO, and I will use a case scenario to give an example for some terminology for echo, which is used to detect the weanable patient during weaning assessment from veno arterial ECMO. Role of echo, either transesophageal or transthoracic echo, depending on the patient echogenicity or the method we used for weaning. All wean patients who show signs of left ventricle recovery if the flow is decreased, and that depends on the ratio of the flow. At each step, we will assess for opening for aortic valve with VTI more than 12 cm, left ventricle ejection fraction more than 20 to 25 cm, S wave, which is detected by tissue Doppler, should be more than 6 cm per second, absence or of worsening of left ventricle distension, or mitral regurge or increased existent mitral regurge. Absence of worsening of RV distension or RV dysfunction. Wean patient shouldn't have ventricular interdependence. How can we detect that? It can be detected by dilated right ventricle and decrease in the size of the left ventricle. The first echo parameter to assess left ventricle function is left ventricle ejection fraction. And for a weanable patient from ECMO, the ejection fraction should be more than 20 to 25%. And to measure left ventricle ejection fraction, we can use eyeballing. This is need an expert eye to assess the ejection fraction. The second is Samson method, which is using to tracing the inner side of the chambers. And the third one is MMOOT, which is in this picture. We can get it through parasternal long axis and put the cursor in the mid cavity. And here we can take the measurement through left ventricle end diastolic diameter and the left ventricle end systolic diameter. And we are putting the equations inside the machine, which give us a short or rapid measurement for ejection fraction. The second parameter for echo parameters for assessment of the left ventricle performance is velocity time integral, or abbreviation of VTI of LVOT of left ventricle outflow tracts. And we can get that through apical Fourier chamber by putting the pulsed wave Doppler below the aortic valve at the LVOT, and we can measure pulsed wave. And velocity time interval means its area under spectral curve, and indicate how far the blood travels during the flow period. So this is VTI can use to calculate stroke volume. And to be weanable, it should be more than 12 cm. The third echo parameter for assessment of left ventricle is S wave. And here we will see apical for a chamber view. And the Doppler cursor will be positioned within the lateral left ventricle wall. And Doppler signal now represents the velocity of the myocardium, which will be termed as tissue Doppler. S wave here will be reflect systolic left ventricle movement, and here we can see it. For ECMO weaning, it should be more than 6. Then if we will go for right ventricle function, so we will measure first tricuspid annular plane systolic excursion, which is tab C. It's linear MMOOT measurement of right ventricle longitudinal function, where we can put the cursor on the lateral wall of tricuspid valve annulus, and we can get from that, and from that we decrease the gain to avoid measuring the noise artifact, looking for constant signal throughout systole and diastole, and identify maximum systolic and diastolic excursion of the annulus motion. Measure vertically via leading edge to leading edge method. This is the picture of MMOOT. So tab C is the distance measurement between minimum to maximum excursion. So here we will measure the distance. It's not slope or a time measurement. Another method to assess the systolic function of RV is by using tissue Doppler and using S-wave. And for that, how can we perform S-wave measurement? Play the cursor over the lateral annulus of the tricuspid valve. Then we will press on pulse wave Doppler and tissue Doppler and also decrease the gain to avoid measuring the noise artifact. Identify maximum systolic velocity above the baseline, which is named S-wave. And if the S-wave less than 9.5 cm per second, that indicates RV systolic dysfunction. Now we will go for ECMO. For ECMO case, this man is 60 years old, post-cardiotomy. And he developed a shock, cardiogenic shock, which required increasing inotropes. And during that time, we did ECMO to take a decision for inserting ECMO. This ECMO for chamber view from a transesophageal ECMO, we will see that LV is not contracting well. And the RV impaired also. This is mid-esophageal, and this indicated this picture before inserting ECMO. This view shows that also there is impaired in the LV. The contractility of LV is severely impaired. And then measurement of LVOT VTI is 8.3. Cardiac output is about 3.1 liter per minute. It's also decreased. This will be the first echo assessment for weaning for this patient. This is apical four chamber, apical four chamber from transthoracic echo, and here we can see the dilatation of left ventricle, which wasn't present during assessment of this patient while he was in ECMO full flow. And there is impairment, as I mentioned before, in the LV function, and also RV function is affected. Here was the measurement of TAPSI. We will find that the measure is about 1 centimeter, which indicate RV dysfunction. And we go for S-wave, we'll find it, it's 5.5 centimeter per second. Both of them indicate reduced RV systolic function, which not the patient not candidate for weaning. Here we will go for ECMO parameters for weaning and where the patient is fulfilled weaning criteria. Here TAPSI, which 1.2 centimeter. However, we find there is mild RV impairment. And if we will go for LVOT VTI, we find VTI 40.9, and if we can remember that the value we need is 12 centimeter, so this patient can be weaned. This TE show four chambers where we can see the contraction of left ventricle, and the RV is greatly improved, and this is with minimal ECMO flow. Another view for LV function, which show better contraction of LV compared to pre-ECMO status. This is on minimal ECMO flow and minimal inotropic support compared to pre-ECMO, which involves a maximum inotropic support in high doses inotropes. Then after weaning of this patient, we did ECMO to see the contractility of the left ventricle after removing the ECMO after 2 days. This is transthoracic ECMO showing that good contraction of LV is 35 to 40% and good contraction in RV. This is 2 days, as I mentioned before, after weaning of ECMO. Another view for chamber view to see the contraction of LV after removal of ECMO. Besides these references, I depend on ECMO also red book. Thanks, and questions can be posted in the comment.